Exposure to a criminal offence can have a significant impact on the child's health and well-being. Experiencing violence and abuse, particularly during childhood, can also have long-term consequences. These may include mental health problems, physical health problems due to the adoption of health risk behaviours, as well as damaged social and occupational skills. Being a victim can also increase an individual's risk of further abuse and of becoming violent themselves. There are several elements that determine the possible short and long-term effects. Age. The younger the child, often the worse the impact. Personal characteristics that could be helpful, such as age, resilience, social support network, etc. Chronicity and severity of the crime. Nature of the crime suffered. For example, sexual violence and domestic violence have different associated risks. Sexual abuse has complex psychosocial risks. In situations where the perpetrator of the crime is unknown, the child may feel more comfortable dealing with the trauma, but it could be more difficult to overcome it if the perpetrator is someone close to the victim. In such cases, children may experience additional feelings of guilt, betrayal, or confusion. In relation to domestic violence, it would be important to assess the level of risk to mothers of repeated violence. The fear of the perpetrator could potentiate the psychological suffering and discouragement in the victim. The EU directive also calls particular attention to victims of terrorism, organized crime, human trafficking, gender-based violence, violence in a close relationship, sexual violence, exploitation or hate crime, and victims with disabilities. In the case of child victims, it's essential that their views are respected in the decision-making process, since that can empower the victim in a significantly disempowering situation. Child-sensitive communication requires taking into account several elements. Using facilities where the child will feel most at ease for the interview. Respecting confidentiality. Ensuring that the child knows what is expected from him or her. Getting to know the child before the interview. Wearing informal attire and a respectful attitude towards the child. Using various methodologies according to the different levels of maturity and learning abilities of different children. Considering the gender of the victim and the nature of the crime. Ensuring a suitable translator if the child is foreign. Avoiding repetitive interviewing. Every child grows in a given environment in which key figures are the parents, guardians, caregivers. Their inclusion in the process is very important, as they can help understanding the child, or they might need help themselves to deal with their experience of the crime, as well as to support the child through recovery. They need to be kept informed throughout the process about all relevant aspects, including the outcome of the individual assessments.